Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi.
Sorry, somebody was saying something. Wa alaikum assalam. We'll just start in a few seconds here, a few minutes. Let me quickly set up the lesson here. Is everyone able to see my screen?
Yeah.
And is the sound quality okay?
Yes.
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right. So let's see. We have 11 people online. Just give them a minute or so. It's just 10 o'clock. So inshallah, we'll get started soon. So how is everyone doing today?
Alhamdulillah.
Okay. And are you getting the messages on the WhatsApp okay?
Hello, yes. Assalamu alaikum, Abid bhai. Awaaz nahi aa raha aapka.
Awaaz nahi aa raha. Can you hear me now?
I can.
Hello.
I can hear you.
Mine is good.
Is it clear?
Is the sound okay?
Yes.
Brother Khalid, check your mic speakers, please. Right, so more people are here now. Okay, inshallah, we'll start. So at this moment, Brother Khalid, are you able to hear me now? Brother Khalid? Okay. All right. Sister Homa, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum.
Okay, so Brother Khalid, are you able to hear me now?
Yes, sir. Sorry, it was my problem, my headphone.
Okay, not a problem. So, can I ask you and Sister Homa to be my assistant and keep an eye on the chat if somebody's asking or saying something? Because sure. When I'm speaking, then hard for me to switch between.
Yes, okay. Yeah, inshallah, we'll keep a chat on this one.
Yes.
Yeah,
and I encourage everyone to say every once in a while something. We are like a family, so no need to worry, just be. Feel okay to call or talk, you know, it's we're all just like a big family here. Okay, so with this introduction, let me just start officially. Nahmuduhu wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem, amma ba'd, a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, everyone.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
With the extreme mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alhamdulillah, that once again we are together and we are going to continue this learning together. And inshallah, today's lecture is very interesting. I'm sure you'll find it very enjoyable and fun. And we'll try to make it fun and we'll learn a lot of things together. And we'll make it easy in the process as well. So let's start with our du'as so that we can put barakah in our session. So qala Allahu ta'ala inna hudallahi huwal huda. Now I'm not going into the translation of these verses at this time, but when we get to the end of the class, inshallah, most of you will be able to understand this or some part of it, right? Wa qala rasulullahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khayrukum man ta'allama al-qur'ana wa 'allama. That, and I would like to stress about this hadith, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best among you is the one who learns the Quran and then teaches it. And this is one of the hadith, is our mission statement, that we're all trying to be the student of the Quran, so that first we learn it ourselves, we get really good at it, and inshallah then we will start, or during that learning we will also transfer it to other people. So sadaqallahu alazim wa sadaqa rasuluhu Rasulul Kareem. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. اللهم ارحمني بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لي إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة واجعله لي حجتين يا رب العالمين آمين
آمين
يسر ولا تؤثر وتمم بالخير. So this little dua we just said, Rabbi Yassir, meaning, O our Allah, make it easy for us. Wala tu'assir, don't make it hard or difficult. Watammim bil khair. And finish it or complete it with khair. Yeah. So alhamdulillah, with this understanding, we are going to start our lecture today. And we will do a quick review of what we did last time so that we refresh our memory and then we go to the next lecture. Okay, mashallah, we have 21 people. Some of the people might be joining soon or they're missing out today, but inshallah we'll wait for them as they come along.
Yeah, looks like brother Ijaz doesn't have the internet.
Oh, brother Ijaz doesn't have it. Not a problem. So if you know anybody who was supposed to be here and you feel that they don't have the information, maybe you can share the information with them. Okay.
Sure.
So before I do this, let me quickly talk about this thing. Let's see. Remember this link I sent you guys? Okay, if you don't talk to me, then I wouldn't know.
Yes, thank you.
All right. So this link was sent, and this is how it looks like. And if some of you don't know what to do with it, basically, this is the link. If you click here, you'll be able to make the fee payment, right? So if you click it, you will see the fee payment here. Okay, so you make $50 and then you pay the fee if you haven't done so. Over here, if you want to know how many classes or the previous classes, the recordings, you click on it and you basically see the YouTube channel. We have session 1 and session 2, and inshallah today the session 3 will be added here as well. So if somebody wants to catch up with the class and they don't know where to go, if you simply go here, click on this link, they will be able to see these classes. Okay, if they want to join the meeting and they don't have the meeting request, all they do, they click on this link and they will be connected to the Zoom on Saturday at 10 o'clock, not before that. Yeah. Okay, similarly, if you are still not part of the WhatsApp group, if you click here, you will become part of the WhatsApp group. And then some links and tools which I have basically added right here in more graphical way so that you don't have to worry about it. So if you look at it, is technically taking you to reciteQuran.com, which is right here. And this is Quran Corpus. And there's another tool called Easy Quranic Arabic. And I have given you a very good resource called 80% of Quranic Words. So if you on your own time, if you would like to increase your knowledge about the vocabulary, inshallah, you can click on this link. And everything is available to you on the internet. Here you can see these are, you can make it bigger. So you can go bigger and you can see what these words are. And we will talk more about them as we go along. I'm just quickly giving you a preview of this page, that what this page offers you. Now, these sessions right here, they will appear like this. If you are on the computer, you can click on them and they will expand like this. If you're on the phone, you will tap on it and they will open like this. Now, I still have to update this section, but so far I have the Arabic conversation. So if you click on this, and let's say your computer doesn't have Office, like the publisher, which is required to play this. So you don't need that because I'm doing it on the internet. So this information, as you can see, now you can play this presentation without much effort. Are we so far so good? This is good enough?
Alhamdulillah.
Okay, so if you didn't know what to do with this, this is what it meant, that I'm just trying to make it easy, and I will keep on adding more information as I have more time. But please click on these links, click on this link if you haven't paid, and Zoom next time. The Zoom meeting invite never changes till the rest of the 10 sessions, so every time it's the same. If you open this on your phone and just click on it, inshallah, you'll be connected to Zoom. Okay. So with that out of the way, let's go back to our class. We had it over here. So how many parts of speech we learned last time? English has how many parts of speech?
Eight.
And how many Arabic has?
Three.
So what happened to Arabic? What they did, they took five of the English ones, like nouns, pronouns, adjectives, adverbs, interjection, and they grouped them together into one. Yes. And the verb is verb, which is same as in Arabic. And the harf become conjunction and the preposition. Do we still remember this from last time?
Yes.
Yes.
Alhamdulillah. Okay. So, do we know what a noun means?
Name and word.
Okay. Anybody, maybe somebody new might be, if they want to tell, what is a noun?
Names and places.
Name of a thing, place, a person, an idea. Technically, everything in any language has a name, right? Like a computer, like some person named Khalid, some person, so there is like a place called kitchen. And these names, can they be specific? Like Abed is a specific name, right?
Mm-hmm.
Boy is a common name. It's not a specific name. But if I say the boy, then it becomes specific?
Yes.
So learn thing about noun that they can be specific, they can be common, and they can be like for everything, person and place and idea and objective. Now, what is a pronoun? Who can tell me what a pronoun is?
Preposition.
Okay, you, I can't hear you very loud.
Instead
and clear.
Of noun.
That's a good definition. So something which is used instead of a noun. Can you give me an example?
He, she, they.
All right, perfect. So if I'm saying a long sentence, I can say, Brother Khalid came to the class. He learned Arabic. Yes. So in the second sentence, I did not say Khalid again. I said he. If I say Fatima went to the market, she bought apples. So what am I saying? That if I need to continue talking about Fatima, instead of saying Fatima went to the market, Fatima bought apples, Fatima then went to the plaza, then I'm just keep repeating Fatima, right? Which is not the nice way of talking. So we say, we mention the name first time, and then we switch over to the pronoun. Everybody good with that information?
Okay. Yes.
What is an adjective, Sister Jahan?
It's a description.
It's a description of a noun.
Yeah, of a noun.
Yes? Like, for example, if I say a tall man or a brave boy or an intelligent girl.
Yeah, so tall and brave and intelligent is adjective.
Like a quality, right? Either the quality could be a good or could be a bad, right? The boy is a liar. Or this man is cruel, or this person is bad.
Yeah. So it describes the noun. It describes the noun. Yeah.
It describes the noun in a good way or a bad way, right? It gives us more information. Now, what is an adverb? Who can tell me? Brother Fahad, can you tell me what an adverb is?
It describes a verb.
It describes a verb. For example, can you give me an example?
It's something that describes time and place. For instance, early, tomorrow, outside, inside.
Oh, mashallah. So it looks like, so you did study, mashallah. Brother Fahad, I'm very impressed. Okay. Mashallah, you're absolutely right. So the easy way to find out about an adverb in an English language, we find the word ly at the end. It's an action, and then there is ly at the end. Slowly, quickly, happily, those things are called adverbs, and they represent a place or a time. Yeah? Okay, good job. What is an interjection? Sister Amirun Nisa. Okay, Brother Khurram, would you like to tell us about interjection?
Sorry, Brother Amit.
No problem. No need to be sorry. Anybody else? Any volunteers? What is an interjection?
Something that connects two sentences, is that what you're talking about?
Okay, but is that conjunction?
Yeah, that is a conjunction. I'm not sure what an interjection is.
Okay. All right. So anybody else who wants to add to the interjection?
Interjection is basically an expression of feeling like, wow, oh, something like that.
Alhamdulillah. Okay. We'll quickly look at that. So just hold on that thought. Now, what is a verb, Brother Waseem?
A verb describes an action.
Okay. Now, what is the main difference between a noun and a verb? What additional information would you like to share with us?
So noun is, as everybody said, that it's kind of name of a place, yes, animal, thing. But yeah, what that person or object is doing. So say Khalid ran. So yeah, ran is a verb that he,
yes,
or is running. So then it's verb can be past tense, present tense, and future.
Perfect. That's what I wanted to hear. So there is a tense. It tells you that action was happened in the past or in the present or in the future. Yes? So that's the main difference between, because a verb, if I say sleep, is sleep a noun? Sleep is a noun, right?
Noun.
Sleep. No. Yeah, okay, but if I say to sleep, is that a noun?
Yes.
Right? But sleeping is telling me that I did an action of sleeping. And that action sleeping is happening right now?
Yes.
If I say slept, does it mean it was done in the past?
Yes. Slept is possible.
Yes. If I'll be sleeping, will be sleeping, that's in the future. Sure. So that tense differentiates a verb between the noun and the verb also, because there is no tense in the noun. If I say Hamid, I don't care whether it's present, past, or future. So just wanted to give you that little additional information so that when we next time we think about it, our minds are clear about that. Okay, Jazakallah khair, Brother Waseem, that was great. Okay, what is conjunction? Conjunction.
Conjunction actually
that adds to phrases to connect.
So connects. Could it be like and?
Yes.
And mm-hmm. But.
Yes.
And like or that. If but.
Yes. But. Good job. What is a preposition? Manal? Sister Manal? Would you like to tell me what a preposition is?
I'm sorry, I don't really understand.
No problem. No, a preposition, remember those words like to, from.
To, from, in, with.
Yes. Now, do they make any sense by themselves?
No.
No.
So what do you need?
Needs noun or verb.
Noun or verb. Jazakallah khairan. Mashallah. So you know it. It's just that it just took a while to get back to you. Okay. So far, this review, are you guys finding it okay?
Yes.
This is a good juggling of your memory?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, good. Alhamdulillah. Yes. Question?
No.
Okay, so I'm going to fast forward to something where we had a problem. So for example, here, did we talk about interjection here at all? Maybe we did not talk about
interjection. No. We didn't talk it last time. So.
Okay, so that's why most of us didn't know what is going on. So let's, yeah. The fail is fine. Okay, harfun, we got it. Now, conjunction, did we talk about conjunction? We didn't talk about conjunction either. But conjunction is like when we say and or things like that. Okay. Now today, before we jump on to this one, let's quickly do this exercise one more time. Okay, this one right here. Okay. So let's do this. Now we will do this quickly because we want to save some time. So we know this we did last time, right? So what is khalaqa? Is it a verb, fail, or ism?
A verb.
It's
a verb. Okay, good. So if you answered it, try not to answer next time. So it is a fail because khalaqa means he created. Okay, najmun. Quickly, somebody just say it.
Noun.
Noun. Good job. All right. Rusulun.
Noun.
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 Ismun.
Ismun. Very good. Okay. Fi. Manal. Manal. Sorry. Sita Manal. Fi. Sita Manal. Aiza. Sister Aiza. Rian. Yes. Anybody?
Yes.
Fi will be? Harfun. Good job. Very good. Okay. Nasara. Some brothers. Anybody?
Failun. Failun.
Failun. Good job. He helped. Daraba.
Dead.
Daraba, who said is? Failun, right? Meaning he hit, basically. Ala. Who's going to tell me that? Arfun. Okay. Now, some sister, I need some sister to tell me. Ala, we did that, right? Okay. Yep. So, let's see. Salihun. Sister Asim. Brother Taj, let's give some a chance to
it's the a noun.
It's a noun. Jazakallah khair. Okay. Tiflun. What is Tiflun?
Noun.
Noun. Very good. Very good. Abada. Do you know the meaning of Abada? He worshipped.
Worshipped.
So yeah. Isa? Zakara, as soon as you know the meaning, you will know the so okay, he remembered, right? Okay, next one. Hold on, everyone. I need somebody new to say. Brother Shaukat, what is the letter Ba?
Brother Shaukat? Sorry, I don't know even the meaning. What does this?
Okay, this is a harf. The meaning is in, with, and it's a harfun.
Harfun,
so,
yeah.
Yeah, so I think you were not present in the last class. So in the last class, what we did, we identified the three basic types of word. In Arabic, the three basic type of words are ismun, failun, and harfun. So this is a example of a harf.
Yeah, I went through the class, but I didn't got time to practice.
Okay, no worries, no worries. So now you know the meaning of ba, right?
Ji.
Okay, so Brother Imran, what is min?
Min means you mean from? The meaning from,
yeah.
So
yeah.
Harfun,
jazakallah. So as soon as you know the meaning, it actually gives you an idea what's going on. Okay, hold on to the thought. I'm going to ask somebody. Rabbun, and I need brother Asim. Did I say your name right, brother Asim?
Yes, it's Asim. Thank you. Yeah, jazakallah. Rabbun is God, which means ism, I think. Ism. I believe.
Very good. Yes.
You should
be confident, no problem, because any name is ismun. Okay, creator. Okay. Allahu, Sister Jahan.
It's a ism.
Very good. Okay. Did I miss anything? No. Okay. So, do we need more exercise on this, or are we good?
Good.
Okay, so was that a good quick preview is good, or do we need more review on this? If you have questions, I can go back and I can give you some more details.
So we'll cover interjection, right? After this?
Or? Inshallah, we'll come to interjection and conjunction. I'll try to find some examples and I'll give it to you. But today's lecture is going to be about... So we have already learned the distinction between ismun, failun, and harfun. Agree?
Yeah.
Okay. So today and in the next few lessons, we are going to focus on the ismun. Our focus will be on what?
Ismun.
Okay. Now, ismun has four properties. Okay. Whenever I say a name, there are four things attached with it. Do you know what those four things are? The four things are gender, number, a type, and status. Okay? So, in order to understand that, if I take the word, if I say a noun, boy, okay? When I say a boy, what do you understand about his gender? Is he a male or a female?
Male,
right? So right away, you knew one detail about the boy. As soon as I say girl, what information you got about the gender of that name?
Excuse me, somebody is complaining they cannot see the screen.
Yeah, Brother Khurram.
Okay, Brother Khurram, let's try again. Can you see it now, Brother Khurram?
Jazakallah khair, I can see it now. Thank you.
Okay, no problem. So, the topic of our discussion today is, we first learn that the word can be of three types, ismun, felun, and harfun. Now we are going to focus on the ism, and we will learn a lot of detail about the ism. So from now on, anytime I say ism, you need to think about four things. And what are those four things? Please repeat after me. The gender.
Gender.
The number, type, and status. Now, I will tell you more details about that, and then we will also talk about the Arabic names for them. But for now, I just want to focus and understand what I'm talking about. So I give you an example of a boy. Now, boy, we know it is a noun. We're talking about any boy, a common noun. Yes?
Yeah.
But as soon as I said noun, what do we know about that boy? We know that gender-wise, he is a male. Yes?
Yeah.
If I say girl is a noun?
Yes.
As soon as I said that, you know that a girl means is female. Yes? Okay. The next detail about a boy, when I say a boy, how many boys are you talking about?
One.
So we also need to know the number of the noun. Like, are we talking about one? Are we talking about two? Are we talking about more than two? Yes?
Yeah.
So in English, we will say one mean singular. Yes?
Yeah.
The two mean?
Plural.
No. In English, you can say it's plural. But in Arabic, for two, we have dual. Meaning two. And more than two will be plural in Arabic. And the word, Arabic word for plural will be jama. Okay, we'll talk about that in a second. So ism, right away I know the gender. The gender pops in my head by looking at the noun. Then also pops up the number. So far so good. Are we okay with this? Okay. Now the third thing is, if I say a boy, is it a common noun?
Yeah.
Yes.
If I say the boy, is it a proper noun?
Proper noun.
Perfect. So the third thing you need to know about a noun, whether it is a common noun or a proper noun. Is this hard? This information is basically, I'm teaching you English grammar for now. Yeah. So what's the third thing we need to know? If I say a boy, is that a common noun?
Yes, that's a common.
If I say Zaidun, is that a common noun?
Proper noun.
Because Zaidun is the name of a person.
Yeah.
Right? The name of a specific person is a proper noun. So you would know the type of the noun. The third thing is the status. Okay? In Arabic, we call them Arab. But that is not the full definition. A status means that what is the role of that noun in a sentence. Okay, to give you an example, if I say the boy went to the school, in this sentence, what is the role of the boy?
Went to school.
He is the doer of the action. He is the one who is going to the school, right?
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? Think about it. When I say status, what do we mean by that? And by the way, we'll spend two sessions on status. So right now, I want you to understand the overall high-level meaning of status. In a sentence, we will have nouns, right?
Yes.
In any sentence, you will have nouns. When you have nouns, what is the role of that noun in that sentence will be determined by the status of the noun. Okay, so example number one. If I say the boy went to the school, the noun here is boy, and he is in the status of the subject. Subject means he is the one who's doing the action. Yeah.
So it's like a verb.
Yeah. Sorry, question?
So is it like a verb?
No. The status of the noun, the function.
So status is a doer?
Status is a doer. I mean, in this sentence, the status of the noun boy is the doer. Another name for the doer is subject. Making sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah. Zaidun hit the boy. Zaid hit the boy. Now the same boy who was going to the school first, was he the doer of the action?
Yes.
Yes.
But in the second sentence, Zaid is hitting the boy.
Mm-hmm.
So is the boy still the doer or he's the subject?
No. He's the subject.
He's the subject.
He's the subject. Now, how do we tell that the boy is in the status of a subject? The status of the noun will tell us that whether he is the doer or the subject. Is that making sense? Or the object?
Yes. Subject is still the doer. So we are talking about object here. So.
Okay. Yes. Sorry. So in the second sentence. Sorry, go ahead. Question?
So, yeah, Brother Abu,
one at a time, please. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. So, how do we identify if it's a doer or if it's something else by looking at the noun?
Perfect. I'll tell you that. So, what I'm trying to say to you today, that first understand high level about ism. Ism has four properties. Okay? It will have a gender, which is either male or female. It's going to have a number, meaning is 1, 2 or more than two. Third is going to have either a common noun or a proper noun. The fourth thing is the status of the noun. And the reason we want to know the status of the noun, because it will tell us that in a sentence, whether that noun is acting as a subject or an object, or the third one, I just need to explain that. Now, moving on, today's lecture will be on gender. And then there will be a lecture on number, and then there will be a lecture on type, and then there will be two lectures on Arab. And when we get to that, I will be writing everything in front of you so that you will understand, and all these questions will be answered in that session. Today, when you think about a status, you just need to know that this will tell me what is the role of a noun in a sentence. Is that good enough information at the moment?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, so today, just please stay with me. Don't get ahead of me. Four things I want you to remember. Let's repeat them. A noun will have a gender,
yeah.
A number, a type, and a status. Okay? Once we get past that, I'm going to give you more details, and that will help you understand even more. But is this information so far enough for you to move forward to the next slide?
Yeah.
Good? Okay. So now the next slide will give you more information. Over here, gender is the first of the four properties of the ism. Let me see what happened to my slide here. Okay. I'm missing something here. What happened? Okay. Oh, I'm in the wrong slide here. Just give me a quick second because I'm supposed to be here. Okay. All right, so this is the right slide. Okay, so we looked at this slide. The next slide, I want you to look at this one. Now, in here, you will find the Arabic words with it too. So what is the noun and its qualities? I'm calling it properties, and we can also call them qualities. A noun is a word that names a person, place, or thing, as in Khalid, museum, or book. It can be indefinite or definite. Indefinite mean it can be a common noun, or definite mean it can be a proper noun. It can be singular, dual, or plural, which tells me about the number of the noun. It can be a masculine or feminine. That tells me the gender of the noun. It can carry any three harakas, the vowels, in which is the Fatatan, Dhammatan, Kasratan. In a sentence, it functions as a subject or the object. Are we good?
Yep.
Okay, gender, number, the definiteness or indefiniteness, I made it simple, I call it type. and the case ending is the i'rab or the status. Okay, now when you say somebody male in Arabic, we call it muzakkar. Okay, and when we say talk about female, we say muannath.
Muannath.
When you talk about the plural, at-tazkiru wa ta'nisu, what it mean when you're telling me whether this noun is a male or a female? Al-adad is the number. Adad mean, is it a singular, wahid, or musanna, dual, or jama, plural? Yeah. And if it's tarif or tankir, meaning is it a proper noun or is it a common noun? And then the status. Okay. So look at the tazkir or tanis, that a noun can be categorized into two categories with respect to its gender: al masculine, al mudakkar, and al muannas, the feminine. Each noun, whether it is a person, place, animal, or thing, is either masculine or feminine. So far, so good?
Yeah, yes. Alhamdulillah. Yeah.
Okay, everybody went so quiet. So I just want to know that
Alhamdulillah.
You're with me. Okay. So now let me give you a rule of thumb. What is the rule of thumb? Every noun in Arabic by default is masculine. What does that mean?
That means it's like always, mostly it's going to be masculine. Otherwise, if it's there are reasons of not being masculine, that we'll discuss, right. I guess, later.
Right. That's exactly what we're going to discuss today. So, brothers and sisters, write this down somewhere, that whenever we take a noun in Arabic by default, we will consider it male. Any noun which comes in front of us, we will say it is masculine until we prove that it is feminine. Are you guys with me on this?
Wait, yes. What are we supposed to write?
Okay, a noun in Arabic is masculine by default. It's written right over here. A noun is masculine by default. Okay? In Arabic, most feminine nouns that refers to human are derived from masculine nouns by adding the feminine marker. This ta here, you see this round ta here? If I say talibun, what is the meaning of talibun? A student.
Student.
But as soon as I say talibun, I know that I'm talking about a male student.
Student.
Like a boy. If I say talibatun, then I'm talking about a student who is a
female,
a girl, a woman. Yeah. These are the people who are living. These are humans. Because a student is a human.
Yes.
Okay. If I say walidun, walidun mean your dad. Then what do you call your mom?
Walidatun.
Walidatun, right? And zaujun, like a spouse. And zaujatun,
wife.
Spouse also, but the female, the wife.
Female.
Zaujun is husband and the wife is zaujatun.
Zaujatun.
What happens? You take the word and you add this round ta at the end of it, then it becomes feminine. Got it?
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay. So we'll come back to this. I'm going to go quickly, like this one. Look at this one. A singular noun is like one person or an entity. A dual musanna refers to two. And a jama refers to two or three or more, right? So the dual is derived from the singular by adding the ani sound. Meaning, if I say talibun, that means a single student. If I say talibani, that means two student. Making sense?
Yeah.
Guys?
Yeah.
The new students?
Sorry,
Ji.
Talibani is two or it's more than one?
Two.
Okay, means it's specific to.
Yes, because we're talking about musanna. Musanna mean two. So if you say kalam, how many kalam mean pen or pencil? Yes?
One.
So one kalam. If I say kalamani, how many pens two. I'm talking about?
Two.
If I say aklamun, how many columns I'm talking about?
More than two.
Okay. So kitabun. Kitabun is a book. How many books? One book. If I say kitabani, how many books I'm talking about?
Two books.
Sayaratun. Now sayaratun is a car. Yes. If I say two cars, I'm going to say sayaratani. Yes. Similarly, when we say jama, so a simple example for jama will be muslimun. Muslimun mean a Muslim or a Muslim. How many Muslim you're talking about?
One.
If I say Muslimani, how many Muslims I'm talking about?
Two.
If I say Muslimuna, how many I'm talking about?
More than three.
So today our subject is not the adad. So I just wanted to give you some examples so that you know in your brain that, okay, this is what we're going to be talking about in the next session, because today our focus is on the gender. Okay. So now you understand.
So Brother Abid, So Tani, if you do the Ani, it's two. What about more than two?
Muslimuna, the Una sound.
Una.
Okay.
So Una would be more than two. Jama.
More than two. Yes. Jama. And we will do a lot of exercises on that. So inshallah, just stay put. We will go and do that, inshallah. Okay. So, and this is the Arab. Okay. So Arab, how do we understand it right now without going into further detail? So if I take the word kitab, is kitab a noun?
Yes.
Okay. So if I say kitabun, that is halat-e-rafa. That is halat-e-rafa. There are three halas or three statuses in the Arabic words. They are known as rafa, nasab, and jar.
Yes.
Say it with me. Rafa,
nasab,
and jar. And jar, right? So if you want to understand in the Arabic, if you see a word kitabun, that is halat-e-rafa. Okay? And halat-e-rafa mean if this word or if this noun comes in a sentence, the role or function of this noun will be subject. Is that making sense now, what I was saying earlier?
Yeah.
There is a subject and there is an object. If I say kitabun, that will be the subject of that sentence. If I say kitaban, that is the halat-e-nasab. And that will make a book an object in that sentence. The role of the book will be what will be the role of the book?
Object.
Now, remember, if I go back to the same example of the boy, I said the boy went to the school. So he was his action was the doer. He was the subject of that sentence. Okay. When I said Zaid hit the boy, then I was saying that he was the object of the sentence. Who was the doer in that second sentence? Zaidun.
Zaidun.
Yes. So what did I say? Zaidun. I did not say Zaidan. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If I say the boy's book, what am I saying here? The boy's book. I'm creating a relationship of the book with the boy. This status is known as halat-e-jar. Halat-e-jar. Jarun. Okay. And then inshallah we will go more and more in detail. So if you look at this information over here, al-baytu kabirun. Al-baytu, the house is big.
Big house.
So who is the what is the function of bayt in this sentence? Subject. Halat-e-rafa. Okay. In the next sentence, I'm saying ra'itul bayta. You see the tu changes into ta.
Nasab.
Agree? Is the halat-e-nasab. In this sentence, it becomes
object.
So halat-e-nasab. Brother Khuram, are you following this?
Yes, brother. Thank you.
Is this helping you now a little bit just to get a visual?
Yes, brother.
And I say ana fil bayti. Ana fil bayti. I am in the house. Yeah. So over here, look at what happened to bayt. Baytu bayta al bayti.
Yeah,
this tells you how this status changes from the rafa to the nasab to the jar. Inshallah, we'll get more details in the next few sessions to come.
Brother okay. Abir,
yes, sir.
So when there's a dhamma, then it becomes a subject. And if it is a fatha, then it's an object. And kasra will be the relation.
Relationship. For now, that information is correct. Okay. But when we get into dual and jama, this rule will change. So stay put. This is only valid when we are talking about singular nouns. Okay?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So far, so good, by the way. Now you realize why in the Quran, sometime it is the bun sound and then the bun sound and the bin sound. Yeah? Yes?
Have you now? Yes.
If you focus on the Quran now, you will start to see these harakas and then it will start to get you to think that, oh, this is the function of this noun is either a subject, object, or the relationship. Yeah? Okay. Let's go. And the short description of the proper noun and a common noun, we already talked about it. We said kitabun, a book. But if I say al-kitabu, the meaning changes from the book. So it becomes from a common noun to a proper noun. Baytun, a house, any house. But al-baytu, a specific house. Furqan, I can see you in the camera. You can turn it off. Furqan. Okay. So, do you guys get it? Baytun and al-baytu. Now, talibun, a student. Is it common or proper?
Common.
Common.
Common. But if I say at-talibu, what happened?
Proper. A student. Proper noun.
Yes? A proper noun. So, mudarrisun, any teacher. A teacher. Al-mudarrisu, the teacher.
The teacher.
Yeah? So, if we go back and take a step back, if I talk about a noun, how many things will come to my mind? Who can tell me?
Four things.
Four.
Okay, Jazakallah. So, Brother Kazim, what are those four things? Can you give me a preview of what those four things are?
Yeah, gender, state, number, status, and
the type.
Type, yeah.
Okay, what do you understand from gender?
So it can be like masculine or feminine. So basically, muzakkar and, muannas. Yeah.
Okay, good. What is the number?
Number is, there can be three types. Like one is singular, dual, and then more than two, which is plural.
MashaAllah, so, very good. Yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
So they are called as...
Wahid,
Musanna, and Jama.
Very good. Very good job, brother. And what is the type?
Type, I actually do not remember.
Okay, type is whether it's a common or a proper noun.
Common or proper, yeah.
Right? And what do you understand about the status as of right now?
So there are like three statuses. One is nominative, accusative, and genitive. Basically rafa, jar, and nasab.
Okay, rafa, nasab, and jar in that order.
Nasab and jar, yeah.
Okay, perfect. And why do we need to know that?
Because it, like looking at the like I mean the based on the ending of the noun, we get to know like which which status it is.
Yes. Yeah. So by knowing that, because this is Arab, belongs to the nouns, it will help us identify the function of the noun in that scenario. Yes? If it's a sentence?
Yes. Yeah.
The
what
noun,
type of sentence?
Yes. The function of that noun, whether it's a subject or an object, or we are talking about something which belongs to the noun, then we have these three statuses. Yeah? Okay. Jazakallah khair. Sister Asmeen, can I ask you a question or are you busy?
Yes.
Okay, so could you please repeat what Brother Kazim was saying, that when we think about a noun, what four things should come in our mind?
The four things are gender, number, type, and status.
Gender means whether it's masculine or feminine. And if it, the word words are by default masculine, but if they are ending in ta, then it means that that's a feminine word. Number is singular, dual, or the plural. And the dual words end in an, and the plural, I don't know about the plural yet. The type are, the type is like, it's a common or a proper noun. If you have an al in the beginning, that makes it a proper noun. And for the status, it means that it's like it, whether it's a subject, object, or there's a possession or relationship between them. If there is a like a, the thing on top, then it's a subject. If it's a zabar, then it's an object, and if it's a zair, it shows the possession or the relationship.
Very good, mashallah. Very thorough explanation. Jazakallah khairan. You are doing great, mashallah. Okay, brother Mansoor, can we talk to you for a minute?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, brother Mansoor. So, when we talk about a noun, what information is coming to your mind?
So, the four properties of the noun from Arabic.
Yeah. The gender.
Gender, status.
Yeah.
Type and.
Type. Yes.
It was singular, plural.
Okay, so that we call number, right? So number. That's right. So we know when we mention a noun, we know the gender, whether it's a male or female, yes, and the number. Okay, what is the number tells you about it? That what are we dealing with when we say number?
So in Arabic, there are three categories of numbers. So
okay,
singular, dual, and multiple.
Plural. Okay, good. Good job. What about the type or the the? What do we know about a noun, whether it's a specific or a common noun?
So if there is al in it, that is a proper noun, but talking about a particular ism, otherwise it's improper noun, generally speaking.
Okay. Good, good, Brother Mashallah, Abed, very good. Yes, sister.
There's some sort of a radio or something background noise. I don't know whose it is. So,
okay, let's see. Yeah. Okay. Brothers, if you have a TV or something playing in the background, please could you mute your mic? Okay, I think it went away now, right? Okay, brother Taj,
it's still coming.
Yeah, brother Taj, can I mute you? Let's see. I think brother Taj was
there. That was him. Yes.
Okay. All right. So, are we good so far, sister? Let me ask one more, sister Aiza. Would you like to tell me about these four properties of a noun?
Yes.
Go
There's
ahead.
Gender, type,
yes.
Status, and number.
Very good. Do you understand what gender means?
Gender means if it's like a boy or a girl.
Okay, good, good. Very good. Good job. Brother Asim, can you tell me about the type? What is the type?
Could you repeat that? What is that?
Question is, in the noun, we have four qualities, the number, the gender, the type, and
yes.
the status. So what is the type about? So when you think about a type, like we talked about definite or indefinite, what does that mean? If I say a boy, what information can you tell me about the type about a boy? A boy.
One boy, he's a gender, and...
Gender is male.
Number
is one, right?
Yeah.
Type is what? It's a common noun, yes?
Common noun, yes, that's
yes.
correct.
So that is what a type means. Kism, uski kya, kism kya hai.
Okay,
jazakallah. Yeah. Sister Amirun Nisa, are you available to talk to us? So, Sister Amirun Nisa, when I say a noun has a status, what information it gives you about that? If you don't know, that's okay.
Status tells us about the subject and object.
Okay. So it tells us the function of that noun, right? Like what is the state of this? Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
Now in the singular nouns, we said there are three harakas in Arabic. The dhammatan, like two dhamma, and two fatha, and two kasra. So when a noun has two dhamma, what a status it is? Rafa. Mm-hmm. And when it has two fatha, it is nasab. Yes? When it has two kasras, then it is jar. Right?
Yes.
Okay, good. So, Brother Fahad, would you like to tell me the same thing about what we just talked about? That when you talk about the i'rab or status of a noun, what information do you have?
So, what information you get? The i'rab shows the function that the noun is playing in the sentence, whether it is an object or a subject. And it is the last haraka that actually tells what the status of that noun is. So if it's a fatah or fatatan, fatatani, then it is basically marfu. If it is dhammatan, then it is marfu.
Yes.
And if it is two fatah, fatatani, then it is basically mansub.
Nasab, yes, mansub, yes.
And if it is kasratan, then it is majroor. It's a jar construction.
Okay. Halat-e jar. Very good. Jazakallah khair. So your understanding is very good. Inshallah, once we get to the examples, then you will start to have more information. Okay, Sister Homa, would you like to add something to that, or you want to repeat some of that information?
Excuse me, Brother Abid, I have a question. Whatever brother the brother just explained, did we cover that in this lesson?
Today we just talked about the status.
The marfu and mansub, whatever. We just
looked at, right? Because halat-e rafa, in the previous session, we said when a noun is in the halat-e rafa, we call it marfu. When a noun is in the status of nasab, we call it mansub. Yes? Remember that part? These are just jargon. We can go over that in a lot more detail in the future sessions. So don't worry, you didn't miss too much. Okay.
Okay, but we did not cover it in our lessons, did we?
We did in the previous session. Yes, we did. In the very first session.
Okay, I missed that one. Yeah. Okay.
Very first session we did it. Okay, Sister Homa, would you like to talk about the status a little bit? Do you want to give us an understanding?
Sure. Okay. Yes. So the status shows the function of the noun, and it has three conditions, which is rafa, nasab, and jar. So rafa will be shown by two dhammas, and nasab, which shows it's actually the accusative or subject of the sentence.
Object
of the sentence, and nasab is the object. So rafa will be the subject. Nasab will be the object, and jar will show the preposition. Sorry, the malikiyat, we say.
Malkiyat. Okay, very good. So you have a pretty good understanding over that. Inshallah, we'll get more details once we start writing on a piece of paper. Jazakallah khair. Now, anybody else wants to add? Okay. Let me ask then, maybe then I can just specifically ask. Brother Imran, what is gender?
Gender is either masculine.
Yeah. Or feminine. Yeah, masculine, okay. Or feminine. Yeah. What are the Arabic words for masculine and feminine?
One is masculine is...
Muzakkar. And the feminine is?
Muannath.
Very good. Very good job. Brother Javed, would you tell us something about the number?
Yes, the number could be single, musanna, dual, and... Then more than two.
Very good job. Okay, good. Mashallah. So, anybody who's still not very sure about this? Anybody? Because we're going to move on to the gender now. So if you have any questions or any confusion, because if we don't clarify the confusion, then we continue and then we'll don't get, you know, we don't get clarification. So is anybody still having any doubt about this? Go ahead. Who's that?
Abid bhai, I'm not very much clear.
Okay,
I just
about
heard
what?
The word muzakkar and oneness.
Yes.
So I know means masculine and feminine. It was a bit clear, means you know now what are okay. These two words and where we're going with this.
So masculine is in English when we talk about a male.
Yeah,
another word for
masculine
yeah.
and so, feminine is okay.
Okay. So but the we need to know what do we call a masculine in Arabic, and for that we have the word called muzakkar.
Okay.
Muzakkar mean a male, right?
Ji. Okay.
Muannas mean a female. So okay. Is that clear or not clear?
Ji.
Okay. So basically we are saying when we take a noun, right? If it's a human noun, it is very easy to pick. If I say boy, you know it's a muzakkar.
If I say
a girl, it's a muannas. But the problem happens when we talk about a non-human thing. If I say kitab, what do you know about kitab? Is it a muzakkar or is it a muannas?
As you said, by default, they are masculine.
Muzakkar. Yes.
Yeah.
So,
muzakkar, yeah.
Yes. So far, we have only just talked about high-level understanding of these four qualities. And now we are going to jump into the gender specifically in this session to figure out that if everything is masculine by default, how can we figure out if it's feminine? And there are some details which we are going to share after the break because there is 11:01 right now. So let's meet after 10 minutes.
Sorry, yes. you said four qualities.
Yes.
One is muzakhir and then another one is...
No. The quality name is gender.
Okay.
Under
okay.
the gender...
Gender,
under the gender you have muzakkar or muannas. Yes.
Ji.
Under the number you have three things: either it's a
single,
dual, or
dual,
more
or
than
plural.
Yeah, plural. Then the type is either it's a common or proper.
Proper noun.
In the status we have the rafa, nasab, and jar. Making sense?
Ji.
Okay. So let's take a break. It's 11:02. We are going to come back after 10 minutes. So don't leave the meeting, just mute yourself and we will continue with the gender inshallah right after the meeting, after the break inshallah.
Inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaikum salam.
All right. Can you guys see my screen with this camera on?
Yes.
Can you see the screen with the paper?
Okay, yes.
Good. All right, good. And are you able to hear me okay?
Yes, alhamdulillah.
Okay. Is everybody back yet? Looks like they're still away. Okay, do we have everyone back yet?
I'm here.
I'm here.
Good, good. Okay, so if you guys are back, then let me try to explain this whole thing again on a piece of paper. Okay, so let me know when to start because I don't want to miss anyone yet in the to understand this. So everybody's back now?
Yes, yes, everybody.
Okay, so we know that we have a word. Yes? And then how many types of words we have?
Four.
Noun. Yes.
Yes.
We have the verb. And then we have the
particle.
Okay. What are the Arabic for this? This is?
Isman.
Kalima. Right? The word is Kalima. Kalima. Noun is the?
Isman.
Ismun, right?
Yes.
Ismun. And the verb is?
Failon.
And the particle is the?
Harakon.
Yes. So we said we are going to learn about the word. And the word is of three types. Ismun, failon, and harfun. And now we are saying, let's focus on the ism. And that ism has four properties. Yes?
Yes.
What is the number one? We have
gender.
Very good. Then we have
number.
The number.
Type.
Then we have the type. Status. And then we have the
status. Status.
So far, so good. I mean, this is simple stuff. We just want to know, like, okay, now what do I need to know? I need to know the gender. I need to know the number. I need to know the type. And I need to know the status. So under gender, either I'm going to have a male.
Muannas, muzakkar.
Okay. Or a female, right? Another word for male is masculine. Another word for female is feminine. And then in Arabic, we call it muannas and muzakkar. Yeah? All right. What is gender? Gender is known as jins. Yes?
Yes.
Okay, the number can be one, or it could be two.
Singular, dual, plural.
Two plus, right? More than two, right? So we can say three, right? So what is the one known as?
Wahid. Singular.
Yes, singular, right? So far, so good. This is English grammar. We're talking about English grammar. The two we call it dual, and we call it musanna.
Musanna.
Yes. And the three is called plural.
Jama.
We call it Jama.
Jama.
Right?
Jama.
Okay. The type is, we know it is a common.
Proper.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Common or proper. Now we will find out the Arabic words for this. We will call it Marifa. Nakira. This is the first time I'm telling you this. Marifa is proper. Nakira is common. And we will get more and more into it when we come to the session of type. Okay. The status is three.
Brother Abed, can you also tell for like Arabic words for number and type? Like just how you told jins.
The number is adad.
Adad.
Okay. And the type we call it kism.
Yes.
And the status is we're calling it Arab for now. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So Rafa, Nasab, and Jar. So people who looked at the presentation before, maybe if they had any doubt, is this information helping them clarify this?
Yes, Alhamdulillah.
Brother Shaukat?
The only thing, I just want more clarification on status part.
Okay. So look at this. Today we are going to talk about noun and these four properties. Yes. And today our focus is on gender.
Okay.
For each of these, we'll have future classes, and this will take at least two classes to understand. So if I jump in this, everybody will be confused. So we'll start from the simple one.
We're
going to gender today. Then we talk about number, we talk about type and status.
Okay.
Today you need to understand, next time when I ask you noun, you should have these four things understood high level, that okay, what are the four qualities of a noun? Is gender, number, type, status. When I talk about gender, I need to know about male and female. When I talk about number, I want to know whether it's a singular, dual, or plural. When I talk about type, is it a common noun or a proper noun? When I talk about Arab, is it a halat rafa, nasab, or jar? These are the top level concept I want you to help me understand. Yes?
Okay.
Okay. So if I say, as I said, I'm going to take the simple example again. A boy. Yes? Now, tell me the gender.
Male.
Male. Tell me the number.
One.
Number. Single.
One.
Singular. Singular. Right? Type.
Common.
Common.
Right? The status, you cannot tell me the status until I use it in a sentence. So if I say, a boy went to the school, right?
Yes.
Is boy is the doer of this action? This is the action, right?
Yeah.
So this is another name for doer is subject.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say the status of this boy is Rafa. And if I have to write this in Arabic, I'm going to say the Arabic for a boy is Waladun. Waladun. Follow?
Yes.
The Arabic for a boy in Arabic is Waladun. If I say Zaid hit the boy. Okay. Now, what was the type of boy over here?
Subject.
Yes? No, no. Type of the boy. Common.
It was common.
Yes. Now look at this. Zaid hit the boy. Is it still common? What is the gender of the boy?
Proper noun. It's proper noun now. Specific.
Yes. So the gender is still male. Number is singular. Now look at the type. It becomes proper. Yes? Brother Shaukat, are you with me? Everybody else is with me? That the boy has become proper? Okay, good. Now, what is the function of this boy in this sentence?
Object.
Is he the object or the subject?
Object.
Right? And Zaid is the
subject. Subject.
Now, when I write this, it will become Wala. So this telling me the status of the noun. Yes? If I say boy's book or the boy's book. Yes? So am I giving you a relationship here?
Yes.
Okay. What is the Arabic for boy, the book? Kitab.
Kitab.
Now, kitabun will always be written like kitabun. Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what is the Arabic for the boy?
Al-walad.
Al-kitab.
No, al-walad, right?
Al-walad.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So, when you put al, then the waw, lam, and this dal. Waladu. Why? Because it's supposed to be, waladun is what? Two fatah, two dhammatan, right?
Yeah.
But when you add al, one of the dhamma drops. Okay. So I'm going to say kitabun al-waladu. But that doesn't sound right. Because when you have the kitabun, this has to be status of jar. Kitabun or kitabun waladi. So understand this. Inshallah, we will come more on this. But I just wanted to give you an example of how to understand these things. Okay. So let's talk about another one. If I say two books, and the Arabic two books will be, one book is
kitabun.
Kitabun. Okay. We haven't heard about the gender definition yet, but we said by default everything is
male,
masculine. So can I say kitab is muzakkar?
Yes.
Okay. So if I assume, because I don't know yet how to distinguish the oneness, we haven't gotten there yet. So I'm saying kitab is muzakkar. So what is the gender?
Masculine.
Masculine. Yes. What is the number?
One. Singular.
Two books.
Two, right? Okay. Yeah. If I say, what is the type? Is it
proper?
No, I mean two books. Am I saying the two books?
Okay. It's common.
Common type.
Sister Asmin has a name, hand. Go ahead, Sister Asmin.
We talked about that the two books are, you put alif and noon at the end to show dual.
You're right. And I was getting there because kitabun is wahid. Yes. And then kitabani will be two books. Yes.
Okay.
So just wanted to give you more details about this, because before I get to the dual, I want to tell you what the singular look like, right? Kitabun. Okay.
Okay, I get it.
Are we good? Are we able to find now the gender, the number, and the type?
Yes.
Is that detail I gave you so far, is it clear in your mind now that what, as soon as I mention a noun, what are the four things should pop up in my head?
Yes.
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 Okay. Do you need more examples, or this is good enough? Brother Khurram, are you good with this? Brother Khurram? Okay. All right. So what I want to do now, I want to give you
the gender.
Your voice is breaking, old brother.
Can't hear you.
Yeah, your voice is breaking out.
Okay, how about now? Is it good now?
Yeah, good.
Yes, good. Alhamdulillah.
Okay, good. Because I think it switched my microphone without me knowing. Okay. All right. So, can we go back to this now, and let's look at some of the details about a gender. There are, Brother Khalid, somebody is still sending information in the chat. Can you please keep an eye on that?
The sound and then
it's just everybody's.
Yes.
Only yes.
Yeah. Is the sound okay now?
Yeah, it's okay. Alhamdulillah.
Okay, good. All right. So, gender is the first of the four properties of ism. We looked at that, yes? Okay. So what do we know about gender? Every word in the Arabic language is either masculine, which is muzakkar, or feminine, which is mu'annath. So now you see those details we just talked about, they're going to start to make sense now, because now I'm using them to tell you the future details, right? The default gender of an ism is
masculine,
right? Or muzakkar. So anything in Arabic, any noun in Arabic we see, by default, we're going to say it is muzakkar, unless we prove that no, it is a muannas. And in order to prove that, we have six categories. How many categories we have?
Six.
Okay. Now, should we learn about all the muzakkar first, or we just should focus on the muannas because it's a smaller number?
Muannas first.
Muannas first, a smaller number.
So, if I ask you next time whether this word, this ism is a muannas or muzakkar, you apply the six categories. If it falls in those six categories, it's a muannas. Otherwise, it is a
muzakkar.
Muzakkar. Okay, so there are six categories of feminine words. What is the, if the word does not fall into any one of these six categories, it is by default a
masculine.
Is that information good enough so far? So good. Are we not getting afraid of this so far? Are we good?
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Brother, there are a bunch of new people. They're just very quiet. You guys have to say something once in a while, just to help me out.
Okay, so the six categories, have you already studied these, or no, are you going to?
We are going to do it now.
Okay.
This is Jahan, we'll take you with us. Don't worry, you're not going to be left behind.
Well, I was getting scared.
No, don't be scared about missing that information. I'm giving you that information right now. Okay. All I'm saying to you, is these word, muannas, muzakkar, gender, is it start to make sense to you now? Like what we are talking about? Okay, so here we go with the six categories. Biologically feminine. And that will apply to anything which is alive. For example, human or animal or things we know that biologically they are male or female, then we know they are muzakkar or muannas. For example, this is the first category. The second category is if the Arabic word has the round tha at the end with the alif hamza at the end or the ya at the end, then that word will be most likely what? Going to be a feminine. And we're going to look at the examples here. So body parts in pair. Do we have two hands?
Yes.
Do we have two eyes?
Yes.
Do we have two nose?
No.
So nose is masculine. The hands are feminine. Eyes are feminine. Follow?
Yes.
Do we have two feet?
Yes.
Yes.
So feet will be feminine.
Feminine.
So
feminine.
Now if I mention to you body parts, human body parts, then anything which is of two is feminine. The rest is masculine.
Masculine.
Okay. Do I have one tongue?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is tongue masculine or feminine?
Masculine.
Do I have two lips?
No.
Yes.
I don't have two lips. That would be really bad if I don't.
Muannas.
So the lips will be muannas. Right? In Arabic, we call them shafatain. Shafatain means two lips. And there is one of the ayah that did we not give you two lips? Did we not give you a tongue? So the two lips mean that it is a muannas, right? Body parts in pairs will be muannas. Is specific names of places, and we will go into that. So there are some specific names of places, they will be considered muannas. Non-human plurals, what do they mean? We'll get to that. And the feminine, because the Arab said so, right? Because this Arabic language is made by us or the Arabs?
Arabs.
Okay, so if they call somebody feminine, can I argue with him that why you call it feminine?
No,
because they are the one who made this language, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Now, Urdu mein, some people might know Urdu. We have a word called kursi. Yeah? Now, kursi in Arabic might be a male, but in Urdu it's always female.
Yes.
I always going to say meri kursi. If I'm the guy or the or a woman, I'm always going to say meri kursi. I'm not going to say mera kursi. Yeah,
you mean the chair?
Yeah, the chair.
Okay.
Urdu.
Okay.
In Urdu language, from the Urdu perspective, the chair is feminine, but from the Arabic perspective, it's masculine. Making sense?
Yeah.
Kitab in Urdu is feminine, meri kitab. I don't say mera kitab.
Mm.
But in Arabic, kitab is masculine.
Yes.
Follow? So you have to see every language, they have their own rules. If I say, oh, look, in Urdu, kitab is feminine. Why are you Arabic people calling book, male in your language? I can't do that because the Arabs decide what they want to call their thing, what they want to call, right? So let's talk about the category number one. So if I give you ukhtun, as long as you know the meaning, can you tell me whether it's a male or a female? Ukhtun?
Female.
Female.
Ummun, mother. Is it a female.
Male
or a
female?
Okay. Bakaratun,
cow. Female.
Female. Female. Is it a male or a female? Female, female. Right? Female. Is it a human or an animal?
Animal.
But can you biologically tell me if this is a cow or a buffalo?
No.
You can, right?
No.
I mean, Bakaratun is female, but if I say buffalo or what do you call the male cow? A bull, for example.
Yes.
Is it going to be male or female?
Male.
Male.
Because we know that biologically they are identified as male. Similarly, when a word has three letters, and there's another quality here. Remember the second quarter, the category was when there is a ta, this round ta, there is a alif and hamza, or there is a ya. So when there is a three letters and those three letters are followed by hamza or ya or the gol ta, then they are considered feminine. Okay, for example, the word zikra, how many letters are there?
Four.
Yes, yeah. The dal, the kaf, ra, and ya. So is the ra, is the ya at the end?
Yes.
So this word zikra is feminine. Why is it feminine? Because we just said in this category, if there is a ya after the three letters, then this is a feminine.
Mm.
Am I going to argue about that?
No.
I just need to learn this. Okay, somebody is complaining about my voice breaking up. Is it better now or is it still breaking?
Alhamdulillah, it's better.
Okay, Sister Aiza, are you able to hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, good. Now, look at this one. In the word hudan, on the other hand, how many letters we have?
Three.
Two.
So,
three letters, right?
Three.
But
the ya is after the two letters. Is it after the three letters or two letters?
Two letters.
So this word hudan is not going to be considered feminine. Why? Because it does not belong to this category. The rule is not met. Yes? So zikra, three letters, ya, feminine. Hudan, on the other hand, is three letters, not three letters, so it's going to be non-masculine. Are you with me so far, guys?
Yes.
Just specific to three letters only.
Three letters, yes. So we have to follow what are we saying in the categories, right? So let's keep on going. Inshallah, you'll find it will start to get make more sense to you in a little bit. Okay. As for the tha, almost all words that end in a tha are feminine. Now, what do we call this tha? We call it
Ta marbuta.
Urdu mein bolte hain golta. Kya bolte hain? Golta. Or circular ta. Or ta marbuta to be very specific. Okay. So if I give you these words, al kubra, is this feminine?
Yes.
Why is it feminine, by the way?
Because there is a kaf ba ra, there are three letters.
There are three letters, and at the end there is a ya. Yes. Over here, al-ula. So it is also feminine male. Because of this.
No, because ayn and lam is only there. Alif lam is the gender. Or also the type. I'll make it proper now.
No. This word is feminine. Okay, just simple is that. Al-ula is feminine because of this rule up here. Okay, look at the alif and hamza. Is hamra u? What does hamra mean?
Red.
Okay. Yes, go ahead.
This al kubra, you said it's feminine?
Yes. It's feminine, yes.
So the
condition is minimum three letters, you said?
Minimum three letters.
So maximum, it can be any letter. So minimum.
Right now, we just stick to the wording it says, right? Because this comes out of the grammar book, not from me. Yeah. You're saying when a word has three letters,
so now
it's those three letters are followed by the ya or the hamza alif, then we know it's a feminine.
Yeah, so in
Al-Kubra, Al-Kubra, because we're not counting the Al, yes?
Okay.
We're not counting the Al, yes? So, Ka, Ba, Ra, yes.
Sorry, but that does not, the three-letter rule does not apply to Al-Ula, right?
Because yeah, that's why my question was there.
Okay, you are right. So, maybe this is the typo, okay? Let me clarify this and I'll get back to you. But think about this rule in the way it's written. If there are three letters and there is a ya, then we know that letter is feminine. Can we agree to that?
Yes.
Okay, good. So look at the hamra'u. Hamra'u is following by the hamza and alif?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is feminine. And sauda'u. Now sauda'u is, see in Arabic, the colors can be male and female, by the way. Okay. In Arabic, the colors can be male and female. So the male for Hamra will be Ahmar. Ahmar is red. Hamra'u is female. Female red. Yeah, or masculine. Aswad is masculine. Black. Sauda'u, female black. Okay. Similarly, we also have this in Urdu. We have Neela and Neeli. We have Pila, Pili. Kala, Kali. Yes. No, not Kala. Kala
or Kali.
Okay, so just giving you a reference that in different languages, they could be male and female for certain things. So colors are also male and female in Arabic. Now, Rahmatun, if you see this word Rahmatun, is it masculine or feminine?
Feminine.
Feminine.
Why? Because of that round ta at the end. Salatun, is it masculine or feminine?
Feminine.
Because this tamarbuta. Inshallah, we'll do some examples later if we time permitting. But you know, I thought that I'll be able to finish one gender in one session, but looks like it we might not be able to. We may have to give another session to this. Agree?
Yes.
Yes, Inshallah.
Okay, body parts that comes in pairs are feminine. Okay. So we need to know them before we can know them, know the meaning. So hand, what do we call hand in Arabic?
Yad.
Yadun.
Yadun. Why? Because by default in Arabic, we write everything with the un sound, right? Oh, yadun, yeah. Muslimun, kitabun, kalamun, right? So yeah. We will say yadun. Yadun mean hand. Do we have two hands?
Yes.
So it's feminine. Aynun. Eyes, right? How many eyes we have?
Two.
So feminine.
Feminine.
Mirfakun, elbows. How many elbows we have?
Two.
In the ayah of the wudu, you'll find al-marafiku. Al-marafiku mean your elbows. Wash your hands up to the elbows. Inshallah, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, you will find this. Okay. Shoulders. How many shoulders we have?
Two.
Mankibun. Yes. The word for shoulder is mankibun. By the way, is this also adding to your vocabulary?
Yes.
Alhamdulillah. Ears. How many ears we have?
Two.
Uzunun. Okay. Legs. How many legs we have?
Two.
Rijlun. Okay. Now look at the difference between rijlun and rajalun. What is rajal?
Men.
And rijlun?
Legs.
So can you call a man legs?
No.
See, if you change that one haraka, the meaning changes drastically, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yes?
Yes?
Okay, how many cheeks we have?
Two.
Hadun. Okay? How many heels we have?
Two.
Akabun. Akibun. Right? How many lips you have?
Two.
Shafatun. Okay? How many feet we have?
Two.
Kadamun.
Kadam
kisko kehte hain? Okay.
Steps.
And shins. How many shins we have?
Two.
Saakun. Now remember that ayah. Saaku bis saak. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains death, that when the time of death comes, the shin, the two shins go closer to each other, and they, because the soul is getting out of the body. So now, inshallah, with some of these words, when you read Quran next time, you will, because each one of these names are mentioned in the Quran. Okay, right? Sakun is shin. And now, ankles. How many ankles we have?
Two.
MashaAllah. So, qabun. And that is also part of the ayah of the wudu, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wash up to your ankles. Are we excited, by the way?
Yes.
Somebody's thinking we should be excited because anything
I'm
we learned.
I'm excited, some confused.
Okay, confusion about what?
No, I mean, you know, these words are just like new for me, especially for me. Yeah. I don't even belong to that culture, I don't know nothing about them. So okay, these are just surprising words, I have to learn before I can just go further.
Yeah, no problem. But see, I'm making it easy by giving you the English version with it.
Easy.
So, alhamdulillah, no need to worry. The very first thing we should do is throw all stress, all worries out the window. Because, alhamdulillah, sooner or later, at least we are now getting to know this. Yes?
Yes.
Now, we read Quran every day. We listen to the bayan every day. We listen to the khutbah every day. But we don't know these words. And what is stopping us? We are professionally doing very high, sophisticated jobs. But when it comes to our own language, we are lacking all this. So, inshallah, there is no worry. Their eye, durust eye. Yes?
Inshallah.
English mein kaise kahenge? How do we say their eye, durust eye?
It's better late than never.
Yeah,
better late than never.
Okay, good. So now we know the body parts. Okay, now not only that, we know that the body parts, we know that as soon as the dual body parts are mentioned, we know it's, they are feminine by gender. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Now, hand in Arabic is feminine. Urdu mein, male. Mera haath. Meri haath koi nahi kahega. Yeah?
Yes.
Jin logo Urdu aati hai, wo bolenge, meri aankh. Mera aankh koi nahi bolega. So, usme, Urdu mein, Arabic mein, they're both in Arabic and Urdu, they are both feminine. Yes? But hand is masculine in Arabic. No.
In
masculine
Urdu.
Urdu, but feminine in Arabic. So it's good to know from for the reference, right? Okay. Specific names of places. For example, most specific names of the places are feminine. The word school or masjid is not a specific name of a place. So school and masjid is not feminine. But if I say America, or Makkah, At-Sudan, Yathribu, or Yathribu, Misrun, Al-Maghribu. What are these? These are
name of the places.
Feminine. These are the specific.
Okay.
If you're going to say why, because the Arabs said so, not because I'm saying it. Okay. But there are few exceptions to this rules. For example, they didn't talk about that. I heard somebody had a question, I think. Somebody had a question?
No.
Okay. So when we get to the number part of the session, you will know what plurals mean. But right now, just read this, that these are non-human plurals. Sayyaratun, cars. Masajidu, masjids. Kutubun, books. So what are they? Feminine. Okay. Now let's look at this one. These ones are feminine because the Arab said so. The Arab said these are feminine. So we are going to just follow them, right? Okay. Yeah. When they talk about a war, harbun, it is feminine.
Feminine.
When they talk about the sky, sama'un is feminine. Shamsun, they talk about the sun. It is feminine. When they talk about the nafs, like nafs is our person, right? Ourselves. Nafsun, feminine. What about narun? Narun mean fire. Fire is feminine.
Feminine.
Dalugun, bucket. Yes? A bucket is feminine in Arabic. Sabilun. Sabilun is what? Path. Or when we say fi sabilillah, what does that mean? In the path of Allah. Yes. Tariqun, also path. Like a road or something. So that is also feminine. Asa, a staff, lathi, you know. Ardun, land. Rihun, wind. Okay. Birun means a well, like a water well. Darun means
house.
Yes. Kasun means a cup. Is feminine. Khamrun, wine. Yes. Jahannamu will be used feminine. Sairun is hellfire, another name for Jahannam.
Yes.
So the name of the fires are feminine. The names of the drinks are feminine. Are you with me so far, guys?
Yeah, and I noticed that everything has got a Dhamma or Dhammatain except for one. Asa.
Asa, okay. Well, it is Asa'un. You can put Dhamma, then it's a typo here. You can put Asa'un. That's Asa'un. No problem. Okay?
Only these specific or...
Say that again?
So these are the only ones which Arab says feminine or there are many?
Well, these are most of them. Because see, when I say... Yeah, for example, let me tell you some other categories. The name of angels will be feminine.
Okay. Like khamarun is wine, right?
Sharabun. Yes. So, anything with the drinking or like drinks, they will be all feminine. So yes, there is more words in there, but I gave you some to keep you going in there, inshallah. So the name of winds is feminine. The names of drinks, feminine. The names of angels, feminine. And some of these words, shamsun, nafsun, samau, these are all feminine. Okay.
What about moon? Khabarun, is it?
Okay, sorry. What was it?
Just a question. Like sun is there. So is it like all bodies like moon or planets or no?
Yeah, there are more. But for now, if we can focus on these, this will cover quite a bit of our vocabulary. Okay. So let's look at this one. Okay. Look at here. During a harb. Harb is what?
War.
Feminine. A soldier was daydreaming. Okay. Looking up at the sama. Sama is?
Feminine.
The sky. Right? Feminine. Until the shams came up. The sun came up. When he snapped out of it, he realized that he was the only nafs. He's the only one left on the battlefield. Nafsun?
Feminine.
He was surrounded by nar. Fire. Right? So he used a dalu, a bucket.
Bucket full of water.
Full of water to make a sabil.
Road.
A path, a way, right? For himself to a safer earth.
Road.
A safe place, right? Earth means the land or the earth. In the heart blowing ri is wind.
Wind.
He was desperately looking for a beer. Not the beer, the bear, the well, the water well.
Well,
draw more water from.
Yeah.
In his search, he found an empty dar, a house, inside which there was a kas, a cup, full of khamr, of wine.
Wine.
He remembered his fear of Jahannam and Sa'ir, and he used his asa to strike the drink. Because if this cup was full of water or chai or mashroob or Pepsi, he would have drank it, right? But it was full of wine. So he said, no, I remember Jahannam and the hellfire. And he used his staff to strike the drink. So this is story. As you know, this is a made-up story. But it has the usage of all those words we just looked in the previous slide. And they're all feminine by nature. So far, so good?
Yes, I love it.
Okay. So today, because of this this session becoming long, I could not do my Arabic conversation and also I could not finish the Quran. Now, if you allow me, we have 10 minutes, and if you allow me at least 15, then at least we can talk about some Quran. Would you guys be okay with that?
Yes.
Inshallah.
Okay, good. Now, inshallah, we'll talk more about this, but I think today we did cover a lot of material. Sister Homa, you're saying something? Somebody saying something?
No, it wasn't me, sir.
Okay, no worries. Okay, so the verses we want to talk about today will make us very, very happy. And we will find out something which we don't know or we don't remember. And once we know this, our worship or our good deeds, inshallah, will go up. Yeah? So this is from Suratul Ghafir. Ghafir means the forgiver God, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who likes to forgive. Yeah? It's Surah number 40. And the verse I'm talking about starts with this. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alladhina yahmiluna al-arsha wa man hawlahu yusabbihuna bihamdi rabbihim. Alladhina, those who bear al-arsh, the throne of who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa man hawlahu, and who are around it. Who are these people who are holding the
whole,
Malaika, the angels who are holding the throne of Allah and who are around the arsh, what do they do? Yusabbihuna bihamdi rabbihim. They glorify the praises of their Lord.
Lord,
right? So they are glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while they're holding the throne and they are in the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then what are they saying? وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا and believe in him. These angels, do they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
Yes.
Okay. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ and ask forgiveness. They are glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while they believe in Allah. And look what they're doing. They're asking for forgiveness. Who are they asking this forgiveness for? Lillazina amanu, for those who believe. Okay, right away. Are you one of those people who believe in Allah?
Yes,
we do.
Did you know that these angels are making dua for you? Were you aware of that before?
No.
Do you know that on a daily basis? Are these angels only doing this one time a day or some hours, or they are doing from the beginning of time?
The beginning of time.
And they will do it until the end of time, which is for us the day of judgment. So we didn't know that since we say La ilaha illallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these angels are who believe in Allah, they're holding the arsh of Allah, and they are in the company of Allah. They are glorifying him. And at the same time, they are also asking for forgiveness for us. Now tell me, what would you pay a person in this life who is making effort for your protection? Tell me.
Thank you, Minister.
Do you have enough thanks for that person who is constantly making dua for you?
No, I don't think so. We can pay him.
Right? So imagine, we didn't know this. We thought we are Muslims and we are most of the time we're not even happy. Or we're always sad, or we think because the state of the Ummah is so bad and the whole thing around us is so depressing. But if we knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has master plan and he knows best and we are just going through the flow, as long as, remember in the previous session we talked about the people who believed in Allah and they stood firm on it. Remember?
Yes.
Remember we talked about last time? So these verses should increase our iman. It should increase us in hope and happiness. Are we feeling that way or not?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
So look what they're saying. Rabbana, our Lord, wasi'ta kulla shay'ir rahmatan wa ilma, that you encompass all things by your mercy and knowledge. Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy everywhere and his knowledge? Yes. So when you need something from somebody, do you glorify them? Do you say nice things to them?
Yes, we do.
Yes.
So they are saying to Allah, Ya Allah, you are covering everything with your mercy and you know everything. So what you do, or what are we asking you to do? Faghfir. Faghfir what? And forgive.
And forgive.
Who? Lillazina taabu. Those who repent. So they are asking for forgiveness and they're saying, Ya Allah, making a request to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, forgive those people who are repenting. Do we make tawbah all day long?
No.
But we do in the salah, right? If we are, alhamdulillah, if we are praying, by default, we are asking for tawbah.
we do it five times.
Okay, but still, if after reading this ayah, would it encourage you to increase the tawbah?
Yes, absolutely.
Right?
For sure, yeah.
Right? So at least now I know that somebody on my behalf is constantly making zikr and constantly asking forgiveness for me and also requesting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me provided I make tawbah. Yes? وَاتَّبِعُوا سَبِيلِكَ. So they are making the tawbah. And what are they doing? And they follow the way. Sabil. Did we just look at Sabil in a few minutes ago? Sabil was the path, right? Sabilillah, Allah's path. Sabilika, your path. Kaifa haluka, how are you? Sabilika, your path. Whose path? Allah's path.
Allah's path.
Because who are they talking to? Who are they making this dua to?
Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of them? Because they are the one who's holding the throne and they are in the presence of Allah. They're saying, Ya Allah, those people who are seeking forgiveness and they're following your path, and you have encompassed everything with your mercy and your knowledge. Waqihim azab al jahim. And save them from the punishment of the hellfire. Did we just look at the azab al jahim? What is jahim?
Hellfire.
Is it mu'annas or muzakkar?
Mu'annas.
Mu'annas. Very good job. MashaAllah. Okay, good. Are we feeling this? Are we feeling this excitement or this goosebump on your hair, your skin?
Yes.
Look, if we don't feel that, then we need to really sit down and ponder that this is the book of mercy. This is the book of knowledge. This is the book of wisdom. And this is the book full of guidance and good news. By reading just these verses or just one verse, alhamdulillah, I am feeling happy. Yeah? Yeah? Or at least I have the desire to become part of this group. Meaning, I want to believe in Allah more by after this. Mera yakin, my faith and my firmness in my iman will grow. And if I haven't been doing my tawbah and following the path of Allah, I make intention that inshallah I'll follow because I want to be included in the dua of these angels. Agree with me? Yes?
Yes.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Ameen. Okay. Rahmatan. Is rahmatan masculine or feminine?
Feminine.
Okay. Very good. So we say wasi'ta. Okay. Is it masculine or feminine? Apply to those six categories. Apply to those six categories. Are they part of those six?
No.
It's masculine.
No, it's masculine.
If it's not part of that six categories, by default it is?
Masculine.
Masculine. Is it a human or a non-human?
Non-human.
It's
a non-human.
Human.
You. Vaseta. No, we're talking about Vaseta, right? We're talking about this body.
Yeah, you. Okay. You in tempas. Yeah.
Okay. Azaba. Did we look at azab in the feminine category?
No.
No.
So azab is going to be?
Masculine.
Masculine.
Yes. Al-Jahim.
Is feminine.
Feminine. Because we know that Jahim is the name of a fire. Hellfire. Yes.
Hellfire.
And we know that this is because the Arab called Jahim feminine. So we said feminine. Agree?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now let's look. So look at the word. The angels who carry the throne and those around it exalt Allah with praise of their Lord and believe in Him and ask forgiveness for those who have believed, saying, Our Lord, you have encompassed all things in mercy and knowledge. So forgive those who repented and followed your way and protect them from the punishment of the hellfire. Ameen, summa ameen.
Ameen.
Okay, now look at the next verse. Are we ready to look at the next verse?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Okay, look.
Brother Abed.
Yes, sir.
At Vaseta, isn't it a verb?
It is, it is. You're right. See, he caught us. Good job, brother. Is it brother Asim or brother Wasim?
Wasim.
Jazakallah khair, brother. We got carried away in our excitement and we didn't focus on that. But good catch. Yes, it is a verb. Yes. Okay. Rabbana wa adkhilhum jannatin. Or jannati adnin. So then they're making further dua. He's saying, O Allah, and admit them in the gardens of Eden. Or meaning the forever gardens. Allati wa attahum. To those you have promised them. Did Allah promise us through His messenger that if we follow His Quran and Sunnah and we believe in Him and we don't do shirk, is He going to give us Jannah?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So the dua is continuing. And look what else they are saying. That Ya Allah, enter them in this Jannah you promised them. And who else should go there? Wa man salaha. And whoever was righteous. Is saleh, you know, when you say somebody is saleh, what did that mean?
Righteous.
So, wa man salaha min abaihim. So, not only those people who believed in you and making tawbah and doing, you know, and following your path, not only them, but their fathers. Wa azwajihim, and their spouses. وَدُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ and their offsprings. You want to go to Jannah alone, by the way?
No.
Do you want to take your family with you?
Inshallah.
Definitely.
So do we need to work on our families?
Yes.
Yes, we do.
Right? So in this dunya, if I say, okay, I want to go to Jannah and I'm going to pray, I'm going to fast, I'm going to give zakah, I'm going to do all the good deeds, I don't care about my wife or my children or my family or my granddad. We want to do it as a collective effort. Okay, so look, guys, these angels, without our knowledge, making dua day and night for in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you think it's a blessing to be a Muslim?
Alhamdulillah.
And then look what they're saying. Innaka antal azizul hakim. Why you want to do all this, Ya Allah? Because indeed you are the mighty and you are the all-wise. So they are again glorifying Allah. You know, this is an etiquette of making dua, that you, when you're asking the person who is supposed to give it to you, you say a lot of good things to them. Yeah?
Yes.
Okay. So far so good, that mashallah, just reading two verses made my day, and I'm sure with the same association your day. Right? Now we know this blessing is happening on us every day and we don't know. And look, they haven't stopped yet. They didn't stop yet. They're saying, وَكِيهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ, and protect them from the evils. Is sayyi'a, is it like a bad deed? Evil deed?
Yes.
Right? Sayyi'a is evil. So sayyi'at is the plural of that. So is this a noun? Yes. So does it have a number? Yes.
Yes.
If we look at the gender, it will be feminine. Because we just looked at that the feminine plurals are, the non-living plurals are, they are feminine. Okay. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they're saying, and protect them from the evils. وَمَن تَكِسْ سَيِّئَاتِ يَوْمَئِذٍ فَقَدْ رَحِمْتَ. And whoever you protect from the evils that day, which day? The day of judgment. Then verily, you have bestowed mercy on him. Got it? On the day of judgment, anybody who was protected by Allah from the evil and he got admitted into Jannah, do you think that he entered into the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
Yes. Yes, definitely. Without mercy, he can't.
You can't. So they're saying, Ya Allah, jisko bhi aapne maaf kar diya, then whoever you have protected from the evils, you have actually bestowed your mercy upon them. وَزَّالِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْضُ الْعَظِيمِ, and that is the great success. that is the eternal, that is the utmost success somebody can get. Yes?
Yes.
So what do we know from Hadith and Sunnah? That a Muslim should not rest and stop worrying until he enters the Jannah and the doors of Jannahs are closed behind him. That is the day when you are Fawzul Azeem. That is the greatest success you can achieve, because then there is no exiting. Until that day happens, we still constantly make effort and strive every day to get there, and then we can rest. Making sense?
Yes.
So and protect them from the evil consequences of their deeds. And he whom you protect from evil consequences that day, you will have given him mercy, and that is the great attainment. Yeah. So today I wanted to read from the tafsir, but we ran out of time, and Jazakallah for giving me additional 7 minutes. I hope and I pray that the end of the class, reading these verses together and understanding the meaning, has helped us go get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. And also closer to the Quran. Okay. So Jazakallahu khairan. Subhanakallahumma
wa bihamdika.
Wa nashhadu la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah. Jazakallah. Jazakallah.